Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll explain you beam solid angle of antenna. First, I'll explain you calculation process of beam solid angle of antenna. And at last, I'll be going to explain you one very interesting problem based on calculation of beam solid angle. So let us initiate this video with first agenda, that is basics of beam solid angle of antenna. See, beam solid angle that we measure in form of steradian. So unit of beam solid angle is steradian. And beam solid angle is three-dimensional angle. As if you calculate angle, then that is just two-dimensional angle that we calculate in form of radian. But beam solid angle is three-dimensional angle that we calculate in form of steradian. Right. As if you want to calculate beam solid angle of antenna, then you can calculate it from any radiation parameter of antenna. Like with antenna, we have many radiation parameters. We have electric field, radiated power, radiation intensity, gain, or power density. These are radiation parameters of antenna. Based on these radiation parameters of antenna, one can calculate beam solid angle. See, beam solid angle is three-dimensional angle. We measure it in form of steradian, and that can be calculated from any radiation parameter, right? And as if you want to calculate beam solid angle, then you need to integrate function with respect to solid angle. So here, whatever function that we consider, that has to be normalized function. This function could be a function of electric field, it could be a function of radiated power, it could be a function of radiation intensity, it could be a function of gain, or it could be a function of power density. So as if you want to calculate beam solid angle, then we will be integrating function with respect to solid angle, where solid angle integration is sin theta d theta d phi, where theta is vertical angle, or you can say it is angle with respect to z axis, and phi is horizontal angle, or you can say phi is varying in xy plane, right? If you don't have value of theta and phi, then you will have to consider this value of theta that is ranging from 0 to pi, and if you don't have value of phi, then you will have to consider phi value that is ranging from 0 to 2 pi, right? Now I'll explain you radiation pattern to understand beam solid angle calculation. If you carefully observe, see, you need to be careful when you observe this pattern. See, both patterns are of same antenna, but first pattern that is there with respect to electric field. So this radiation pattern that is there with respect to electric field, and same pattern that is represented with respect to power. So you might be saying like both patterns are different. No, both patterns are same. Only thing is, here we have electric field in pattern and here we have power in pattern. So there are a few basic things that you need to understand. See, radiation pattern with respect to electric field, that is bit broad over here with major lobe, right? And at half power beamwidth, here electric field that will be E divided by root 2. So E divided by root 2, that is 0.707, divided by root 2 means 0.707, right? And at half power beamwidth, you see power is half over here. So as and when you represent radiation pattern in form of power, at that time it will be a bit sharp compared to the radiation pattern of electric field. Now why I am saying you this? The reason is, as and when you calculate beam solid angle, at that time you will be integrating function with respect to solid angle. So what should be this function? Let me explain you what should be this function. See, this function theta comma phi, that should be normalized function first of all, And if you want to calculate that with respect to electric field, then it should be normalized electric field square, right? Or it could be normalized magnetic field square. So based on electric field or magnetic field, one can calculate this function, that is electric field square or magnetic field square. And we need to have this function in form of normalized value. So here electric field or magnetic field, that should be normalized one. But as and when you calculate this function with respect to power, so you just need to normalize power function, right? Or you need to normalize average power density function, right? Or you need to normalize radiation intensity function, right? So this is what you need to take care of when you calculate beam solid angle, right? Now let us have one problem. So here, see, we have been given with electric field. To calculate beam solid angle based on the electric field, first of all, we need to normalize electric field. So if you want to normalize electric field, then normalized electric field will be given electric field divided by maximum value of electric field. Here given electric field is Em cos square theta, and maximum electric field value is Em over here. So normalized electric field, that will be cos square theta. Now we have normalized electric field, right? So based on it, we can identify function. What is the function? See, function over here, that is square of electric field or square of magnetic field, right? And if you have power or average power density or radiation intensity or directivity or gain, in that case, directly by normalizing it, you can take it as a function, right? So here we have electric field. So normalized function in form of theta and phi, that is electric field square. So that is cos raised to 4 theta. Now we have function. So based on it, we can calculate beam solid angle. So beam solid angle, that is solid angle integration of function, right? So here function, that is fn of theta comma phi, and here solid angle integration is sin theta d phi. Here theta and phi, those limits are given to us. See, theta is ranging from 0 to pi by 2 and phi is ranging from 0 to 2 pi. That is given to us. But if it is not given, then you need to consider theta is ranging from 0 to pi and phi is ranging from 0 to 2 pi, right? But here range are given, so we can consider that as per range, where theta is ranging from 0 to pi by 2 and phi, that is ranging from 0 to 2 pi. Now we need to integrate this. So here, see, theta and phi, both limits are given, and function is cos raised to 4 theta. Now with this integration, we need to simplify few things. You see, here cos raised to 4 theta into sin theta is there, and here we have double integration. One integration is there with respect to theta, and second integration is there with respect to phi. So this cos raised to 4 theta into sin theta, that is independent of phi. So as it is independent of phi, you can have separate integration of theta and phi, right? So here separately you can have integration of phi, where phi is ranging from 0 to 2 pi d phi, and here theta's integration, that one can do in separate integration, and you can multiply it both, right? So we can have easier calculation over here. Now see, integration of 1 with respect to phi, that is phi, where if you substitute limit, this will be 2 pi, right? 2 pi minus 0, that will be 2 pi. And here we have theta integration, that is 0 to pi by 2 cos raised to 4 theta sin theta d theta. Now I'll explain you how to have this integration. to have this integration, we can consider cos theta is equals to t. See, if you consider cos theta is equals to t, then minus of sin theta d theta, that is equals to dt. So we can substitute sin theta d theta is equals to minus dt. And here theta is there from 0 to pi by 2. So we need to find limit of t. So t will be there from, see, if you substitute theta is equals to 0 in this, then t is equals to cos 0 means it will be 1. And if you substitute theta is equals to pi by 2 in this, then t is equals to cos pi by 2, that will be 0. So now we can have this integration in form of t, right? So if you do that, then you will be observing this 2 pi that is outside. Now t is ranging from 1 to 0. T is ranging from 1 to 0. Cos raised to 4 theta, now that will become t raised to 4. And sin theta d theta, that is minus dt, right? So here I am saying minus t raised to 4 dt. Now we can simply integrate this. See, t to the power 4 integration is t to the power 5 divided by 5, and limit is there from 1 to 0, right? And here we have minus sign. So if you substitute limits, then if you substitute 0 first, then this term will be 0, minus minus plus, if you substitute 1, then 1 by 5. So this will be 2 pi divided by 5. So this is what solid angle in form of t radian, right? 2 pi by 5. So that is how one can calculate solid angle. So here we have been given with electric field. So first of all, we have normalized it, and function is square of electric field, right? If you have power or directivity or average power density or gain or radiation intensity, then you just need to normalize it, and you can place that normalized value as a function, right? And then you can have solid angle integration to get solid angle. I hope now process is clear to you. Still, if anything that you'd like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.